गुड इवनिंग ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फर्दर अवर सेट्स फंक्शंस चैप्टर्स. राइट नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द अलजेब्रा ऑफ फंक्शंस. व्हाट इज अलजेब्रा ऑफ फंक्शंस? एज द अलजेब्रा ऑफ नंबर्स इज देयर, दैट इज एडिशन, सब्ट्रैक्शन, डिवीजन एंड मल्टीप्लीकेशन, सेम इज द केस विद फंक्शंस एज वेल. दैट हाउ द फंक्शंस विल एडिट, how it will be subtracted, how it will be multiplied, how it will be divided. So this is the new algebra of functions. Right now, addition or subtraction of functions. Now they said let f be function from x to r and g be function from x to r, means both have same domain and codomain. First thing, they must have same domain and codomain. Be any two real functions. Now they said real functions. As we discussed in the previous classes, real functions are what? Real functions are those whose domain and codomain must be R or subset of R. So that means X is subset of R. That is, X is subset of R. Then we define a new function which is the addition of f and g. Then we define f plus minus g or subtraction also, addition of f and g or subtraction of f and g. So f plus minus g will be from same domain to same codomain x to r by f plus minus g of x will be equals to fx plus minus gx. That means if we are taking the image of x under new function f plus g, now this is our new function f plus g, it will be the addition or subtraction of the corresponding limits under f and g. Right, so this will be same f plus g minus f plus minus g of x will be equals to f of x plus minus g of x. Right, now we have one example for this. Example says if we have fx equals to x square, gx equals to 2x. Now both are real functions, no need to find its domain and codomain. Actually these are polynomial functions, so domain will be R and codomain will also be R. Right, so now if domain and codomain are R, then we can add and subtract, right? Both have same domain and codomain. So f plus g and f minus g we can find, and they said to find this f plus g and f minus g. Now f plus g, according to the algebra of functions, f plus g of x will be equals to fx plus gx. Fx plus gx. Now f plus g of x will be fx plus gx. And our fx is what? X square, and gx is what? 2x, right? So now fx is x square and gx is 2x. So x square plus 2x will be what? Our new function f plus g. If we take the image of x under f plus g, it will be x square plus 2x. Next, similarly, f minus g of x will be fx minus gx. So it will be what? X square minus 2x. Clear? Next, we have to multiply a function by a scalar, right? Now they said let f from x to r be a real valued function. Now if it is a real valued function, that means we don't have any idea about the domain. Codomain will be subset of r or r itself. So as we can see, codomain is r itself, right? So now if it is a real valued function and alpha be a scalar, scalar means what? A real number. Then the product function, product of a scalar by a function alpha f is a new function from x to r defined by alpha f of x will be equals to alpha times fx. So this is how a function when multiplied with a scalar, and then the new function behaves as this, right? Now next is multiplication of two functions. Now we are multiplying two functions. Earlier we did multiplication of a function by a scalar. Now we have to do is multiplication of two real functions. the product of two real functions. Now you all are aware what is two real functions. Two real functions means that both domain and codomain are subset of R or R itself for both the functions f and g. Now the product function, a new function fg from x to r defined by f into g of x will be equals to fx into gx for all x belongs to r. For all x belongs to x, because x will be element from the domain only. Domain is our x, right? So now we have one example. They said let fx equals to x square, gx equals to 2x, same example, and they said find the product function f into g. So f into g of x will be equals to fx into gx, which will be x square into 2x. So it will be 2x cube according to the algebra of functions. So these are the simple things, right? Now next is division of two real functions. Let f be from x to r and g be from x to r. These are two real functions. That means both domain and codomain are subsets of r or r itself. The quotient of f by g. Quotient of f by g means f divided by g is denoted by f by g is defined by. Now it is a new function f by g. And how it is defined? It is defined by f over g of x will be equals to fx over gx. Now provided that gx must not be 0. Why it must not be 0? Because denominator can't be 0. So gx must not be 0 for any x. That means for all x, right? So next we have one example. They said let fx be equals to x square and gx be equals to 2x. Then find f by g of x will be equals to fx by gx according to the algebra of functions, right? Now fx is our x square, gx is our 2x. Dividing both, x square by 2x will give us x by 2. So this was the algebra of functions. So this completes our chapter functions and relations and functions. Please see this video very carefully, and we will continue this exercise questions in the next class. Thank you, and we'll meet you in the next class.